One of the first things you want to do is find center of the grill. You can use the emblem as a reference to follow downwards. And here are the center grill cells. With a cell type grill, usually there are a set of cells located in the center. Here are the center cells in this example. Having found the center of the grill, the next step is to hang the central hook. As you can see, there's a nut insert here that can be slid up and down to adjust as necessary. Generally speaking, you want to put the hook through the highest cell and allow it to drop. Once it is through, you want to be sure the adjustable nut is centered to the cell. If not, you can simply hold the hook with one finger and adjust the nut up or down. You then want to take the retainer bracket. Note the fingers on the back, which allow the bracket to rest on the cells. Please note that this bracket can also be turned upside down to change the position of the license plate if you want it to be mounted lower. For vehicles with adaptive cruise control, two hooks are to be placed equally offset to center. The retainer bracket is adjustable depending on the width required. In this application, be sure to tighten the Allen head bolts on the retainer bracket after it is affixed to the grill. Use the supplied thumb screw and insert it through the retaining bracket and into the nut on the hook. Tighten firmly. Take the license plate frame and position it between the slotted fingers. Then use the supplied Allen head bolts and washers and lightly hand tighten them. Adjust if needed. Then take the supplied Allen wrench and tighten the side Allen head bolts securely. For North American license plates, use the supplied Phillips head bolts and insert by hand. Then use a Phillips screwdriver and tighten the screws securely. For rest of world applications, the plate frame has adhesive backings. You can carefully use a razor blade to remove the plastic coverings. Assure that the back of your license plate is completely clean and dry. Apply the plate so that it is centered to the vehicle. There are adhesive-backed rubber bumpers that are supplied with your mount. Apply these either to the back of the plate frame or the license plate itself, assuring that your license plate is clean before applying. These rubber bumpers are positioned so that none of the metal components make contact with the bumper of the car. Assure that you press the rubber bumpers so that they adhere correctly. Your Carbonio license plate mount is now ready for the road.